After Sunnah غير مؤكدة, it is مستحب. What is مستحب? مستحب is something, if you do it, you are rewarded. And if you don't do it, there is no accountability, you are not sinful, and it's not even disliked. If you miss a مستحب, if you neglect a مستحب, neglecting a مستحب, it's not even disliked. Like if you neglect a Sunnah غير مؤكدة, it is disliked, it's مكروه تنزيهي. But if you neglect مستحب, it's not even disliked in Sharia. And the opposite of that is khilafullah. Now mustahab, it's important to know mustahab. What is the requirement for something to be mustahab? What makes something mustahab? Because we claim that gyarvi is mustahab. We claim that a gathering associated with awliya Allah, a gathering established in the names of awliya Allah is mustahab. If someone organizes a gathering on the name of Sayyiduna Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, or if someone establishes a gathering on the name of Khaja Mu'inuddin Chishti Ajmeri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that is mustahab. Meaning if you establish a gathering, you will be rewarded. And if you don't establish it, it's not even makruh tanzihi. It's not even disliked. And the same is the ruling of Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. If you commemorate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, you will be rewarded. There's a reward for it. But if you don't celebrate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, there is no sin. And it's not even disliked in Sharia. Now what makes a mustahab? When does something become mustahab? Mustahab is something, even if it wasn't performed by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, but the ulama of the ummah, if they like it, if they consider it to be a good practice, it is a mustahab. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not perform it, even the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't do it, but the scholars of the ummah, the ulama of the ummah, they consider it to be a good practice, that is mustahab. Take note, this is very important. And the dalil for that is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, which Imam Hakim in his Mustadrak and Imam Tabrani narrates it in Al-Mu'jam Al-Kabir, and Al-Bazzar narrates it in his Musnad, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal narrates it in his Musnad. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, an Abdullah ibn Masud radiyallahu ta'ala anh, qal, فما رآه المؤمن حسنا فهو عند الله حسن وما رآه المؤمن قبيحا فهو عند الله قبيح. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, whatever the believer considers to be good, it is good in the eyes of Allah. So if the scholars of the ummah, if they say something is a good practice, then it is a good practice in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. A very important point, because we'll come back to this. We will place Gyarmi Sharif in this box. And we will place Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in this box. So what is mustahab? If the ulama consider it to be a good practice, that is mustahab. Even if it wasn't established in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And the opposite of mustahab is khilafullah.